all within. Welcome, Dee'z kings and queens, to the very first segment of Sip Tea with Dee, where we come correct and put things in check. So I'm gonna be dishing all the hot tea that there is to dish, and as y'all know, it's a lot of hot tea out there in the pots and pans and the whatever. But I'm not even gonna lie, this week been a pretty dry week, but I'm gonna work with whatever God gives me. Yes, I will. So very first up on the agenda, we're gonna go to Tekashi snitching, testifying against the blood gang or whatever. So as y'all know, Tekashi was arrested back 2018, I believe, on racketeering charges. But if y'all have been keeping up with the media, then y'all know that Tekashi, he's snitching. That's the only reason he getting all this special treatment, from what they've been saying on the online and from his whole case. He has way better accommodations than, you know, the other prisoners. He has a room with a TV, or his rec room has a TV and tennis. And so, I mean, okay, he's living the suburban prison dream, y'all. Yes, he is. But that comes at a cost. So Tekashi has been testifying for the last 3 days against the blood gang. And basically, he was with the non-trade bloods, and he would provide them funding and stuff for, like, guns and everything in exchange for them basically hyping his career and funding his career and all that great stuff. Tekashi, you done sold yourself to the devil. I'm praying for you. But, so he revealed details about his kidnapping. He named names. He checking the list twice, and then he gonna throw Cardi B in the mix. Like, what? He just snitching for no reason now. Like, what's next? He gonna give us a Krabby Patty secret formula? Like, I wanna know. Like, what's making the Krabby Patty so good? I bet he know, though. But that's, but long story short, so after 3 days of testifying, they say he's done, you know, on the stand or whatever. Honestly, Tekashi, I don't know. I mean, I can't sit here and say I would take an 80-year bid like he was gonna probably have to do. But I probably would never got myself in that situation, and that's just me. There's a lot of celebrities, especially Snoop Dogg now. Snoop Dogg, I just love Snoop Dogg. He been on Tekashi neck, and he is not giving up, y'all. He's not letting up. So 50 Cent, I know he used to claim Tekashi as his son, but now because Tekashi snitching, you know, 50 Cent don't get down to snitches. You know, that dude got shot 9 times. I don't even know if they caught his killer. And I feel like he had a pretty good view of his killer, I'm pretty sure, from what I've seen in Get Rich or Die Trying. But long story short, you know, Tekashi, pray for you. We're all gonna pray for you. You know, I really hope it was worth it, because honestly, ooh, baby, sweetie, I'm gonna sip my tea. Ooh, yeah, I'm gonna have to pray for you. I'm sorry. But without further ado, we're gonna keep this train moving. On to a good note, y'all, Boondocks is coming back. Now, if y'all have never seen Boondocks, y'all gotta watch it. Boondocks was basically the black people's Family Guy and American Dad. Now, I'm just gonna be so honest with y'all. Boondocks was my favorite show and then they canceled it. If y'all wanna watch it, y'all can watch it on Hulu. It was good. The fourth season could use some work, but nonetheless, it was good. So long story short, you know, they bringing it back to the HBO's new streaming service, and they bring it back 2 seasons, not one, but 2, baby, with 24 episodes. Now, I don't know about y'all, but I'm finna go out there and give me a little HBO streaming service, because Boondocks was masterpiece. I can't wait to see Huey Big Afro back on the screen and Roddy Little Bad Self running around causing mayhem. And then Granddad with his... I just can't wait. Can't wait for it. But we're going to move on. So next, we have Rihanna's Fenty fashion show. Oh my God, Rihanna. You never just cease to amaze me. But you know what would amaze me? If you would just go ahead and release your album like you've been saying for the last year. But we gonna move on from that. But Rihanna had a Fenty fashion show. And let me just go ahead and tell y'all now. She did that for the culture. It was like watching Beyonce's homecoming documentary. Like, you got the same feeling of pride just sitting there watching it. Made me feel glad to be black. I mean, I'm not saying I'm never glad to be black because black is beautiful. But it made me just... You had a Normani up there. She was dancing her little heart out. You know, I love Normani. That little girl can dance. Yes, or that girl can dance because she's older than me. But I just loved it. And, you know, they was all dancing Rihanna's new lingerie line. I'm thinking that's some pretty good lingerie. If it can take all that dancing and swinging and rocking, yeah, that's some pretty good lingerie. Y'all might want to go out there and buy some, you know. That's, yeah, get some of that. Alright, moving on. So we got The Real or Lonnie Love versus Tamar Braxton. Now, Tamar was on The Real for a period of time and then she left. So she went on the Wendy Williams show and basically, you know, Wendy brought it up that they needed Tamar back or whatever. And, you know, the show really isn't as what it was when Tamar Braxton was on there. So after, you know, Wendy Williams aired that segment or whatever, you know, The Real, or specifically Lonnie Love, had, you know, something to say about it, because she, you know, it's their live, so they gonna say something that's gonna be seen. So Lonnie Love was like, you know, we might be the cute show, but we also the Emmy winning show. I said, oh, I was like, you gonna let her talk to you like that, Wendy? And Tamar? And you know, Tamar, she got a mouth. She gonna say something back. She gonna clap back where the clap back is due. So she clapped back and was talking about how, you know, Lonnie was writing letters while Tamar was in surgery saying she needs to get off the show and they need to replace her with Lonnie. And I was like, well, where's the receipts? Lonnie was like, girl, who still writes letters? I'm not even gonna lie, I don't write no type of letter. The only letters I get from anybody is about bills or something else. So I was like, so who still writes letters? Anything, she would send an email or something saying, hey, kick her off. Or a little text message. Even these days, you might as well just send a little tweet if you want to get something done in the world. But and then Tamar, she's talking about something. She had she wants no parts and insists that she did nothing to start this whole thing. I mean, I wouldn't say you did nothing, but I will say, you know, to each their own at this point. It's above me now. I mean, that's between y'all, but at this point, I have to give it to the Lord, and hopefully he can work it out between y'all, and y'all can come to a, you know, reconciliation, or whatever y'all want to call it. Sit down, have some tea. Like Lonnie said, she invited her to, you know, come sit down and talk to her and work it out. I don't know if that's gonna actually happen, but oh well, that's on them. Next, we got Iggy Azalea versus Wendy Williams. Now, Iggy, I ain't heard from Iggy in a while. I thought that girl was gone in Australia or something. But Iggy, she clapped back at Wendy Williams because Wendy Williams had the nerve to say some. Oh, the girl with the fake body. And so Iggy was like, sweetie, you ain't much realer than me. If you want to be honest, you look like, I can't remember what she said, but she said something. I was like, ooh, Wendy, you should just left that alone. Cause no. If I was Wendy production crew, I would have said something. No, cut it. Cut that out. But she said it and Iggy clapped back, so. You know, it's Wendy. Wendy gonna say whatever come to her head, but Wendy, your production crew don't love you like they should. Cause if that was me, I would have been like, nope, we cutting that out. I don't care if it's live, Iggy. I mean, Wendy, cover it up, fix it, turn it around. Cause we don't need this. We don't need her coming for you like this. Cause you know, Iggy look good. I'm not even gonna sit here and like, Iggy look good. Wendy, you need to pick your battles. But I love you. Next, we have Issa Rae finna make a Set Off reboot. Now, y'all, for these reboots, honestly, I feel like if something good, just leave it alone. Why mess it up? You know, why take something beautiful and try to, that's like trying to take, you know, Leonardo da Vinci's Mona Lisa and make it a Mona Teresa. You know, at that point, it's already beautiful, it's already made history, it's already set its place in the world. Why try to come and knock it off this pedestal? You know what I mean? Or try to go above that pedestal. Like, it's going to be hard because they already done set the bar pretty high. But, you know, Issa Rae, I mean, I love her. She's a really good black businesswoman. I feel like she got, you know, the eye for stuff. But sometimes you need to take your eye and put it on other stuff. You know, this, I don't know how you're going to top Set It Off. Because, first of all, the cast they had for Set It Off, the original, yes, beautiful. I love the black power, black women, black excellence. You know, Queen Latifah, she played the mess out of that girl. She played that. You know, when she died, I cried. It was so sad. So sad. But, you know, and then Issa, she's trying to get it rolling. And I just don't really see which girl Issa could play. Maybe she could play Kimberly Elise's character. You know, the little crybaby that was crying through the whole movie. Or something like that, but I don't see her being Cleo, because Cleo, nah, that was, nah. At this point, if you're going to be trying to beat Queen Latifah character, you're going to need a man, like an actual man. Like a real life buff, just got out of prison with the cornrows type man. You're going to need that to beat Cleo character, because Cleo, Queen Latifah's character, she did that. She set the bar too high. But yeah, we're going to see how it turned out. Hopefully it turned out good. If not, I'm gonna have to leave it alone. Next we got, so y'all know the Emmys was this past week. Long story short, Beyonce didn't win no Emmy, and at this point, the Beehive is pissed. The Beehive wants blood, because at the end of the day, Homecoming, that was one for the culture. You know, that was one that we could all been proud of. Be proud of this black movement. All the work Beyonce put into that. She didn't have to do all that, but whatever. So, Beyonce didn't win for Homecoming, but Leaving Neverland won. You know, I'm not even gonna say it, what I'm thinking. I'm gonna try to dial it down. Beyonce, I felt, should have won. Leaving Neverland was a slander documentary, basically. They slandered the name of a dead man. Michael Jackson been dead for years, y'all. And y'all still on this Neverland stuff. Neverland is closed down. Neverland is done. At this point, we all left Neverland. Because guess what? It's closed down. Ain't nobody getting in. So at this point, how I feel like Beyonce's Homecoming documentary was one for the culture. It was something that people could be proud to watch and feel proud to be African American. It just made you feel proud. Leaving Neverland had me just sitting there like, so we still on this? We're still talking about this? This is not over yet? The man is dead. At this point, what can you do? Like, how can he get punished for anything that's been done? You know? Like, I'm not saying, okay, we just gotta, no, I'm saying let it go, let it go, let it be gone, let it prosper, don't let it prosper, but, you know, let it be gone, get over it at this point. He's gone, he's dead. Whatever he done did, done went to the grave with him. Ain't nothing, no greater punishment can be done to him than him being 6 feet under in the ground. And guess what, he's already there. Like, this man's whole legacy just gonna end up being, you know, basically him being a sexual predator or whatever. And that man was so much more than what people are trying to paint him out to be. years after his death. At this point, y'all should have did that when that man was alive. Because at least then he could answer to it and respond to it. Y'all making a whole documentary about a dead man who can't even fight for himself. I mean, his estate can fight for him, which they said something like, oh, that's, it's funny how they won this Emmy over a documentary that was built on false accusations. Michael can't respond. But guess what? If Beyonce had won, she could have responded, said thank you, held up the Emmy, been like, I appreciate the support, but y'all didn't want to do that. Y'all wanted to just, I swear, I feel like America is just built on negativity. I'm just going to be honest. If it's not negative, guess what? It's not going to get out there. And I just can't. But, you know, Beyonce, you won in my heart. I'm just going to say that. You won in my heart. But there's one for that we can, there's one win we can't take for the culture. Colin Kaepernick's Nike commercial won an Emmy, so I'm proud of you, dog. I'm happy for you. You know, you did set forth the motion, and we stand behind you 100%. Now, I'm going to tie up two and one because they both kind of have to do with each other, but I'm going to leave it alone. So, Antonio Brown and Kevin Hart. Antonio Brown is facing sexual misconduct charges, claims, you know, a woman is claiming that he hired her to paint a mural, and then he walked in there butt naked and was just putting his thing in her face. You know, maybe he was confused about what type of mural you were supposed to be painting. Maybe he thought you were supposed to be painting his whole mural, you know, but Antonio Brown been going through it, sir. I hope you clean up your act soon or whatever. I mean, you know, yeah. And then Kevin Hart, y'all know Kevin Hart just had that terrible car accident. Hopefully he's recovering well. But after hearing this news, his back might go out again because he's facing a $60 million lawsuit according to some lady that he was the man in this sex tape that was released. Sweetie, at this point, you know, you kind of chose the wrong time to be trying to hit somebody with a lawsuit. This man is probably in the hospital still, sitting there in the bed. You should have waited until he at least up on his feet again, you know, making movies or something. That's when you probably should have hit him with this lawsuit, but to each their own, I can't really help you there. But Kevin Hart, hopefully it all works itself out. I feel like the girl personally is lying. I feel like, I don't know how, unless you can actually, like, unless it's like R. Kelly video or whatever, then I can't really see how he gonna face any charges, because, you know, Hollywood protects their own. Hollywood will go out on a limb to protect their money makers, and Kevin Hart, honestly, right now, he's still a money maker. No matter how much people say they don't like watching him no more, that man's still making money. So, but I'm gonna deuce this. I'm gonna end all of this. I don't want to always end on a negative note, so I'm gonna throw some positivity in there. Positivity. So, some positivity for the black race. Yes, we have Kanye West, Jay-Z, Drake, and Diddy are the highest paid hip-hop acts of 2019. Yes, y'all, they did it. They did it for the culture. They did it for us. Yes, I mean, they did it for their bank accounts, too. What's up? But, yeah, they are the highest paid hip-hop acts of 2019. I am so proud of them. I hope, you know, we can have more black excellence like that. Also, just to circle back to Rihanna's fashion show, one for the black culture. I love this. That was beautiful. That was lavish. You know, that was Victoria's Secret. Who? Victoria's Secret fashion show. Where? Rihanna, you done knew. You done. Here's the bar that you done set, and here where Victoria's Secret's at right now. You did that. So, without further ado, I'm gonna go ahead and wrap this up. I hope y'all guys enjoy it. please be sure to like and subscribe and leave comments on stuff that you probably want me to hit up on the next segment, because trust and believe, it's gonna be another segment. But I did it, y'all. I came correct and put the things in check. Moving on. See y'all when I see y'all. Arrivederci.